So I had taken hundreds of photographs in the square, and largely I was collecting these photographs of these signs for myself. I thought it was just they were just so unique and so amazing and so evocative. And then as time passed and Hosni Mubarak stepped down, and I spent a lot of time looking at my photographs, and a friend sent me a post on Facebook or something saying, look at my Flickr set. And I looked at his Flickr set. It was Amr Suleiman, who was a friend of mine, who was an amateur photographer. And he had posted a lot of beautiful photographs from Tahrir. And he had a lot of photographs of people holding signs with very powerful messages. So I called Amr up and I said, look, I mean, all these amazing signs out there, and I really think they should be collected. Would you let me use your photographs if I put together a book? And he said, yeah, sure, use whatever you want. So I started looking at his photographs, and I started exploring other Flickr sets, and then I started looking on Facebook and looking at people's albums. And to make a very long story short, I looked at 7,000 images from Tahrir over those 18 days between the start of the demonstration on the 25th, demonstration between the 25th of January to the 11th of February, Mubarak stepped down. And I limited myself to Tahrir, and I limited myself to those 18 days, I limited myself to the signs. And of the 7,000 photographs, I picked 150 images, and what I would do is when I would find a photograph that I wanted, I would then write to the photographer and ask them for their permission to use it. Everybody said yes. What I was looking for in the photographs was what the message said, what the sign said. I was also looking for what the material the sign was made of, because some people wrote on cardboard, on wood, on themselves, on their clothes, on their foreheads, on their hands, on shoes. I was also looking at who was holding the sign, so I tried to make it as representative of the kinds of people I saw in the square as possible. I tried to include, obviously I couldn't include all the different kinds of signs, there were thousands, but I tried to include one from each of the main tropes that I had seen. So there were very funny signs, for example, that said, oh, leave already, my arm aches, and there are hundreds of that. So I chose one that would illustrate. There were many signs that were done on the ground, sort of in graffiti, or written out in rocks, or stones, or cups, or candles, or even date pits. And I've got one of those photographs taken by Rania Helmi of the word leave in Arabic written in stones. But you could do a whole book on the signs that were written on the ground in Tahrir and the different materials they were written in.
Now, may I ask you, why are these photographs so important as a historic documentation?
Well, I think they're important because really it was the first time that the Egyptians had found their voice in such a public way, and different kinds of Egyptians found their voice. I mean, it wasn't just a bunch of activists standing in the square, but it was really a cross-section of society. There were old people, young people, rich people, poor people, people from the countryside, people from Upper Egypt.